like to call the June 9th, 2016 Western Reserve School Board meeting to order. Have a roll call.
Brian Bennell.
Present.
Richard Bevins.
Present.
Melissa Fox.
Present.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay.
All right, good evening. What you're about to see here is a brief presentation with a whole lot of work behind it. This stems from the Foundations and Communications class, which is one of the college credit classes from YSU. And part of the requirement of YSU's course is to find a problem that you believe exists in your community or in your school, research it, look for answers, talk to all people who potentially are involved in this, and come up with a solution. And so this particular group, of which Amy Seeds and Hannah Hebner were the only two brave souls to come forward tonight to present this to you, they identified a problem of our grade scale and what seems to be an unfair disadvantage that our current grading scale puts our students at in terms of scholarship competition with other schools in the area. So they are going to talk to you about that tonight.
There's four other members in the group and they all were working with that. They did a lot of research on this, did a lot of background, and presented this to the teaching staff.
I know school's over, but I think they should get extra credit.
Yeah. Don't steal their thunder
now. We were fortunate enough to get a copy of the board policy that was adapted by our school in 2007. And these are two quotes that we're taking from the policy. The first one being, the board approves the grading and reporting systems as developed by the faculty upon recommendation of the superintendent. And the second quote is, the board believes students respond more positively to the opportunity for success than the threat of failure. And both of these are very true in the grading scale for our students.
According to Mr. Melito, this is the grading scale that was adopted since the school was established, and the current 7-point scale is an A is a 100 to 93, a B is 92 to 84, 83 to 74 is a C, a D is 73 to 65, and an F is 64 and below. Not only does this grading scale put our students at a major disadvantage when it comes to class rank, but it also impacts their GPA and possible scholarship opportunities in the future.
We were able to use some of the grades from Mr. Henderson's English class in the past year and compare it to the 10-point grading scale. So basically what we did is we took the percentages that could have been used in the 10-point grading scale compared to our current grading scale. And in the first 9 weeks, we found that 20 students would have went up a letter grade if we were on the new scale. And the second 9 weeks, 15 students would have gone up. And the third 9 weeks, 8 students would have gone up. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean a student goes from a B to an A. This could be a student goes from a B to an A, a C to a B, or a D to a C. So they're going up one letter grade just if we were to change the scale.
The College Credit Plus supplied was by YSU. The classes are required by YSU to go by the YSU grading scale, which is a 10-point scale, and that improves their GPA no matter which grade they get because it automatically registers to a higher percentage in letter grade, and that also raises class rank.
Many of the students their junior and senior year also transferred to the MCCTC to finish up their schooling. And the MCCTC also goes by a 10-point grading scale. And at the end of their schooling, they go by the MCCTC scale. And say a student here at Western Reserve gets a 92B, and a student there would get a 92% A. So automatically, the MCCTC student would go up in class rank, even though both students have the same grade. And this gives our students here at Western Reserve an unfair advantage.
This is USA scholarship chart from Malone University. This is only for 1 year, each number is only for 1 year, but they can all be renewed. And of course, ACT and SAT scores are also inputted into this data. But as you can see up here, even a few tenths of a GPA point can greatly impact the amount of money you can get from year to year. And that is a big deal when it comes to scholarship opportunities because college costs a lot.
So this was our proposed solution that we came up with our group. And of course, it was changing to the 10-point grading scale. Now, what exactly is the 10-point grading scale? Well, it's when the percentage goes by 10 points per letter grade. So an A would be a 90 to 100, a B would be an 80 to 89, a C would be a 70 to 79, and so on and so forth. And we came up with a bunch of different solutions, and the best one we came up with was to make an immediate transaction into it. So basically, grades 9 through 12 would be old grading scale 1 year and then transfer over to the new one the next year. And all the grades that they got before that would stay to the past scale, but all future grades would transfer to the new scale.
When we presented this to the high school faculty, we asked them to take a vote on their opinion and about the subject, and only one teacher was against our proposition, and they even told us in the comments and came to us later and told us that in terms of just scholarship opportunities, they were in favor of our proposition. So overall, the teachers were very receptive and very positive towards our proposition.
A big majority of our high school staff was for changing the grading scale. And for all good reasons, too, if we were to change it, grades could increase, not percentage-wise, but letter grade-wise, and that affects your GPA, which can also, in turn, affect your chance for scholarships and your college opportunities. So we hope that our presentation here has encouraged you to change to the new grading scale as well. Does anybody have any questions for us?
Did you guys happen to check with any other local schools to see, kind of like our neighboring schools, to see kind of what other high schools are doing in the area? Or?
Yes, we did. We actually took all of the schools in the Mahoning County and to see what their grading scales were, and about 60% or more of them had the 10-point grading scale, and then the other ones had the traditional scale. And Canfield actually just transferred over to the 10-point grading scale after being on the 93 to 100 scale for a very long time. So.
And when they did the vote was 18 to 1. Staff felt that just with now Mr. Molito contributed a little bit with the amount of money that the kids are missing out on based on the higher grade scale and affecting their GPA, as well as competing with other schools whose kids have a better GPA and better class rank. So it does affect them financially as well once they graduate.
I do think one of the maybe the most unfair thing of all is what the kids showed, that we're not even consistent within our own school building. Mm-hmm. When you've got one English class on the YSU grade scale, and the kids who aren't in the YSU class on a different grade scale, and then MCCT kids, who then their class rank applies with the kids that are here in our building on a different grade scale. It's really, and that's when you look at college scholarships, they ask for GPA, class rank, and they say, are you in the top 10%, the top 5%? Well, when we're not even consistent within our own building, that really creates a problem, I think. Even more so than trying to compete with other school systems, too.
Good point. Mm-hmm. Good point.
Good job.
Nice work. Certainly a valid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they did a lot of work with this. Took them a while. There were, how many groups did you have to do different projects?
There was three groups this semester and two groups the first semester.
So they've all done their projects and presented them to the staff. And
mm-hmm. One group did safety, parking lot safety, because we've been having a lot of problems with driving in the parking lot. So one group studied that, another group looked at no place to sit at baseball games, softball games. So they did research on locations, types of bleachers, the kind of thing, and presented that to Mr. McGlynn.
One group did the cross country course.
That was in the fall.
In the fall.
Another group did trying to take care of potholes in the county. And obviously they weren't successful in terms of the results, but they probably learned more than any of the groups this year about about the rigmarole and the runaround you get from county offices. And they They had a lot of people not returning their calls and not returning their emails, and a lot of people passing the buck off to other people. So they learned a lot, you know, from that process.
So we thought we'd show you a little bit of what they're doing and what their research was and what they're thinking.
That's awesome.
Good.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We'll take it under consideration.
Thank you.
Treasurer's recommendations. It was recommended that the minutes of the May 19, 2016 regular meeting of the Western Reserve Local Board of Education be approved as mailed to each member in advance of the meeting.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried. Recommended that the May 2016 financial reports be approved and the May listing of bills be approved as mailed to each member in advance of the meeting.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes. Motion carried. It is recommended that the board approve the expenditure adjustment of the full balance from the emergency levy fund 016 to the general fund 001.
So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board approve the in lieu of transportation reimbursement for the 2015-2016 school year as follows. Payments to Rita McIntosh, Joanne Simon, Cecil, and Eric Galligan, and Lisa Wilson.
So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. Superintendent's recommendation. It is recommended that the following extracurricular contracts be approved for the 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
Awesome. So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended to approve the contract for special education and related services, alternate program services, and other services as individually specified and defined in the agreement with Mahoning County Educational Service Center for the 2016-17 school year at an estimated cost of $416,599. This amount will be deducted from the district's state foundation payments and paid to the Mahoning County ESC.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended to approve a one-year teaching contract for Cabrilla Zerdawi, all right. Beginning with the 2016 school year at BA Step 1 of the current salary schedule in effect.
So that's the French teacher.
She took that
test. Did get her license, right. I think, the day after the last board meeting.
Perfect.
So she's all good.
Good.
Great. Second.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes. Motion carried. It is recommended to approve the installation of electric winches for the basketball hoops in the reserve building gym at an estimated cost of $11,000. Victory Athletics will provide the materials and installation. Tri-Area Electric will do the electrical wiring.
We've looked at this, and if you've been in that gym, the way they raise and lower the hoops is with a handheld drill on a chair. We've been very fortunate that's not been an issue. So we've kind of been looking to where we can get that work done, and it's going to be the key. Basically, it's just a key that is inserted and turned, and the hoops will come up for an assembly or for something, and they'll come down the side hoops for practices. So I think money well spent.
Agreed.
Well beyond the time we should have had. Mm-hmm. We're ready to do it now. So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried.
On this next one, if I can interrupt, I'm not sure where we want to go with that, because we had some quotes, and there was some discussion on, I gave you the copies of the most current that we have. Everbright had given us a quote of $6,800 for 4 inches total, 2.5 inches of the base asphalt coat, and 1.5 inches. And we had a proposal from Pantalone that was only 3 inches, 2 inches of the base and 1 inch. We had originally thought the 4 inches would be better. That's going to be on a turn area, and it's going to be on the visitor side, where we talked about taking out some curb for handicap parking, handicap access to the visitor side of the stadium. They're going to use that ticket booth that's the visitor's concession stand. We were thinking the 4 inches because any traffic is going to be turning on that pad. That being said, with the Pantalone price being lower but only 3 inches, we tried to get a hold of them to give us a quote for 4 inches, just to compare apples to apples. The owner is out of town and won't be in town until Tuesday or Wednesday next week. So you can look at the price comparisons. Everbright was there, that second page was for 3 inches, the same as Pantalone, and you can see the difference is about $900.
Yeah, I thought there was a half inch of difference. I didn't appreciate it was a full inch.
Yeah. So I don't know what, you know, yeah. We can, a couple things. One thing we were looking at with the scheduling of the sealing of the parking lot, we were looking to do that around the 4th of July when there's no activity up here. So we were hoping to get that work done. We have no commitment from Pantalone that they will be able to do that work.
I'm fine if Everbright's your direction.
You know, what the other thing we can do, and I don't know how we might need to do that, is if we get a hold of Pantalone and their prices is that much less.
I'm fine. Anybody have any objections with allowing them to proceed?
Do you think the 3-inch or the 4-inch? I mean, it's a good base there. Like I said, our thought was there are some buses that go back there for baseball and softball. You know, and that turning, and to be honest with you, it'll be wide enough the buses can probably make that turn. But that was our only thinking, is because it is a turn, does that put a little more pressure on the pad? Whatever you guys think.
I'm good as recommended.
Okay.
So okay. Moved.
Great.
Second.
I think he should read it first.
Oh.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
It is recommended that the board approve Everbright Inc. to complete the asphalt work for the visitor side handicap stadium entrance at a cost of $6,800. Rich, motion. Missy, you second.
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. Thank you, Kevin.
Mm-hmm.
Next item on the agenda, approve the job descriptions for the following positions. One of those job descriptions are in the packet.
I gave you almost all of them last meeting, and then I just got to you tonight. I didn't get to you earlier like I thought I would, but the school nurse / safety coordinator, bus mechanic, and the K-5 guidance and 6-12 guidance, because they're a little bit different, because 6-12 guidance is working more with seniors and scholarships and that type of thing. But a lot of the guidance followed the framework for the evaluation, which is a new policy that will come up in a little bit, and following along with that and the things that they're doing, and kind of gave that to Danielle and Greg to see, you know, what do we need to add, what do we need to. So pretty much covered that. Talked with Gary Conrad as far as the bus mechanic thing. Talked to Nora as far as the nurse and some of the things they do. And so I think we're pretty good with all those job descriptions and current and fairly up to date. So.
Thank you for putting the work in to do that.
Sure.
A motion to approve that?
So moved.
Second. Mr. Daniel?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
It is recommended, the motion carried, is recommended that the board hire Damian Biente as the assistant varsity football coach for 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Bagno?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board hire Joe Stevens as an assistant varsity football coach for the 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
So moved.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes, motion carried. It is recommended that the board hire Jason Cochran as the varsity or assistant varsity football coach for the 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board hire Timothy Hall as the junior high football coach for the 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board hire John Deal as the junior high football coach for the 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect. I assume they're splitting that contract.
I'm sorry, John Deal?
Yeah.
He's the assistant.
There's two contracts.
There are two.
Yes, there are two.
Thank you.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
It is recommended that the board approve Sean Gardner as an unpaid volunteer junior high football coach for the 2016-17 school year.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you,
Sean.
Thank you.
It is recommended that the board hire Kevin Conway as the cross-country coach for the 2016-17 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes. Motion carried. It is recommended that the board approve Angela Knopf as an unpaid volunteer assistant cross-country coach for the 2016 school year.
So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board hire Christine Hughes as the seventh grade volleyball coach for the 2016 school year as per the salary schedule in effect.
So moved.
Second.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board approve the following athletic workers: Megan Brotag, Paige Yeager, Katie Maloney.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried. Recommended that the board add Robert Malcolm to the classified substitute list.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Motion carried. It is recommended that the board add Paige Yeager to the certified substitute list.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Blevins?
Yes.
Mrs. Potts?
Yes.
Mr. Bennett?
Yes. Motion carried. Building principal report. Anything to share, Doug?
You doing the addendums or no?
Yes.
Pardon?
Oh, okay.
Did you give me one?
Yeah, you gave me one. I thought we got done. It's been a busy 2-3 weeks. No?
We want to skip. We've got more. We've got your.
Yeah, there's no action taken on.
Okay.
That's just the reading on the.
All right. Okay.
Last couple of weeks have been a little bit crazy and a little bit busy. We've had the senior Raritan dinner at a la carte on the 23rd, which 18 of our seniors attended dinner with the Raritans. That was the night before we had the spring sports banquet on the 24th at a la carte. So Shelley was kind of getting used to seeing everybody at the same place. We followed that with on the 31st with our senior scholastic banquet. All those kids that were 3-5 and above, and I know you guys were all there. We honored 20 seniors with 3-5 and above, one junior, and four sophomores with 4.0s. And again, that's something the Raritans help pay for quite a bit. They contribute most of the money towards the plaques
and also the kids' dinners and their guests. The following week, we went to the boat regatta on Friday, the junior high boat regatta, which was a great success. The winning team, once again, hauled 15 people in their boat made of cardboard and duct tape, over 2,000 pounds, and didn't sink. So it did pretty well. The first boat that went down, the captain was down with the ship, lasted 17 seconds. So it barely got in the water and they sunk. But they tried to do it, you know, they tried. So that was at Mars Lake, and we were sending Frank and his family a thank you note. Yesterday we did the junior high awards assembly. We honored all the kids with the honorable mention, honors and high honors, honor roll. All the kids who participated in the English Festival, the boat regatta, the VFW writing program. There were a lot of kids were honored in the course of the hour and a half that we had so many awards. Actually, this was probably one of the longer ones we've had because we had so many kids receive awards, which is great. Today they finished with the junior high field day, which when they came in at the end of the day, it was not pretty. They did not smell well, but they were outside playing. We also had senior breakfast this morning and practice for our seniors for graduation Sunday, which starts at 1:30. Last week on Thursday, Tom Reardon came and did a presentation all day to our math teachers in the class, to our kids, and showed them the calculators, how far it's, how it works, and the navigator. And I think you were in on that, weren't you? You were in that, Eric and Chrissy. We did purchase our T-Inspires this week. We went with 40 and two navigators. In the fall, we'll pick up the other 20 and another navigator for our third math class. And tomorrow, Tom is coming to do 8 to 3:30 in service with our math and science teachers as part of this, part of the program of getting it. If you remember, we were looking at two different curriculums. We were looking at Carnegie and we were looking at the T-Inspire. Talking to both people, they thought that if we threw two curriculums at the high school at one time, it might be too much. So we're looking at the Carnegie, possibly for the junior high 6, 7, 8. The problem with Carnegie, and we're trying to negotiate a little bit with them, is it's the upfront cost. You pay up front, but you have that license for 6 years, you never pay again. But the upfront cost is a little bit. If we did 6 through 12, we're looking at about $50,000. Where if we only do 6, 7, 8, we can cut that beyond half, hopefully. So we're negotiating, trying to space out over a couple of years with them. I know Kathy's over here. Good to see her. But so we're currently looking at that as well. And I think that's about it. Graduation Sunday, 1:30. I think you guys, I think, have to be here around 1:15. And Debbie's not here. She's, I forget where she was at. She had to take Matt to a baseball game.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Sean, do you have anything for the board?
Just end of the year stuff, and you know, this is a good, really good group of seniors. I hate to see them go, but it's time, I guess. And it's a bittersweet thing for me because I like the challenge that they give me in the classroom, you know, because I could always be on my toes when they ask questions and that kind of thing. And, but you know, I'll be looking forward to seeing what they do in the future because I expect big things from this class. So, but I look forward to, you know, the classes next year. So, wrapping things up, that's it.
We didn't move quick enough.
Well, it's your turn.
Oh, good.
She's on the hot seat.
He was just saying we should have moved on quicker.
You didn't go fast enough. Oh, okay.
So I think it was safe.
We had a really good end of the school year. Today was the last day, just in case you didn't know. It was a busy week this week. We had, between last week and this week, we had field day. It was wonderful. It was good. The public sliming and the whole business, but the kids did great. We had a really nice award ceremony yesterday. A lot of students got awards, some special awards. We started something called the Bug Award, bringing up grades, because it's nice to get good grades, but it's really nice to be recognized for bringing your grades up and encouraging kids to do that. When we started, we've been looking at the end of the year, and I'll continue to do that, looking at some of our scores. Not scores, but just how kids perform, benchmarking, how far they've grown in reading and math. And it's looking really good. We have students that, one thing that I'm very impressed with is we have our lower level, some of our special education students who moved up between 2 and 4 reading levels, which is huge. I mean, we're like a year and a half to 2 years worth of growth. Enormous. So that's kind of a foundation for everything. And those I feel pretty confident in because their Fontes and Pinnell, pretty standardized, but the teachers measure them. They benchmark them every 9 weeks. So pretty good stuff. I've been working with our building level committee, and we're looking at kind of changing the way that Title I tutors work, being a little bit more targeted. We use them a lot for testing and benchmarking and things, and I don't like that. It's increased, and I think it's increased because of the accountability and all the testing. So we're going to go back. We're going to relook at that, rethink that. Really looking toward next year. The girls down at the elementary have already said, well, we'll be in next week. And I said, really now? That's great. That's wonderful. I'm happy that they like to work. I am. But so it's good. Any questions?
No. Thank you, Debbie. Jeff, you want to review?
Yeah, some of these policy. The evaluation of school counselors will be a new policy, and proper procedures involves 2 readings of any new policy. So basically, this would be a first reading, and this is all right out of the Ohio School Board's policy that we subscribe to. I believe we approved that last month, and it's really worthwhile. They send updates, and you should have copies of the new policy, which is the evaluation of school counselors. There's 2 of them because their system, they actually locate that same exact policy in 2 different places. One is under, I forget what A and G even stand for, but one would be under school policy development, and the other would be under instruction or students. So it's in 2 different headings. It's the exact same policy, and it deals with the evaluation of school counselors, which has to begin actually this September. So they've come out with new frameworks on to follow with that. So technically this is a first reading, and we'll do a first reading on these revisions, and then at the next meeting we'll approve everything at the same time. I apologize for the extensive red on the College Credit Plus, but that's our life, the way they keep changing things with College Credit Plus. And what I decided, and basically following along, because of the amount of changes, we have some of these guidelines in our policy, and then we would repeat some of those same guidelines in our regulation for College Credit Plus. So you'll see 2 pages, and again, the same type of filing system. It's under 2 spots in the policy book, but the red is all going to be eliminated, and we'll just keep it a very general policy statement. And then our regulations get more specific to what the steps are that are followed, what are the timelines. There are hearings going on or have been in Columbus, both pro and con for College Credit Plus. A lot of schools now, juniors that are finished school today, can actually enroll in summer school at the university at our expense. So it's getting to be kind of a real money drain. It's a good program.
It starts in 7th grade?
Pardon me?
It starts in 7th grade?
That's...
Really?
If they meet the requirements, okay. If they have the ACT score, yeah, down to 7th grade. Paying for their books, paying for... So we've kind of got some things started. We've been collecting their books so that they don't turn around and sell their books. Right. We're paying for them. They're our books. You return them to us. And done some things with buying used books through some of the now online, unlike when I went to school, you had to go to the bookstore and buy books. Now you can rent books, you can get things online, so we're trying to save a little bit there. But, huh? Yes, they did have a bookstore back then, delivered by wagon. So anyway, the yellow is the additions, and you can see on page 3 of that, College Credit Plus, that's the summer term eligibility. You know, the argument for the summer term is, but they're still only allowed 30 credits of College Credit Plus. So they, but just now they're spreading it out over potentially 3 semesters as opposed to 2. And then now a lot of colleges are doing online courses. So not only are we paying for them to get college credit, but they can sit at home and do online courses and get college credit and high school credit. There's a lot of talk on that. So I'm sure more will change, and that's why I wanted to try and get that very closely in line with what OSBA will be updating, and it'll be easier to update that. The data and records retention, really the only change, and again, we talked about this, how they make these changes and don't realize the impact it has, but it's no longer called the Ohio Historical Society, where records that are no longer kept are sent, or at least offered to. It's now called the Ohio History Connection. So everywhere we had Historical Society in our policy, we had to change to History Connection, or HC instead of HS. That's that change. Programs for students with disabilities, just one change on that file, IGBA, and that basically includes children for whom the district is district of residence, having been court ordered to juvenile detention centers. So, and that's basically the same thing in our regulations on that. That's the only change for that one. And those are the revisions and new policies that we have. And like I said, this will go as our first reading of that, and then we'll approve revisions and new policy at the next meeting. So following right along with OSBA, just a couple things I wanted to get to you, because next meeting I'd like to approve our winter head coaches. So these are the evaluations that Jeff Martig did for this past year's Steve Miller for girls basketball, and Patsy Del Torio for boys basketball. So you can look those over. We won't go over them right now, but those guys will be on the agenda for next meeting. Also in your folders, I gave you a press release. We are about to flip the switch on our solar energy. The electricians have been here the last couple days, and tentatively a media release will be on June 16th. I'll update you at 9 a.m. if you would like to come and be before the cameras and flip the switch to put that online.
I'm reading here. I think it would be good to explain to the public exactly what the framework of the deal was.
Mm-hmm. I plan on putting that in the newsletter that's coming out. Yes.
But even anything released to the media, I think, needs to have a brief explanation that, you know, it's not the district's money.
Right, and I think she addressed that, where she said that no upfront money. It's just basically we're buying the electricity produced by that at a lower rate than what we would buy. You know, so that's our reason to get into this.
Yeah. You know? Okay. Yeah.
So that should be on schedule. I did contact Tri-County with the wind towers. They are not able to reuse any of that metal because that was special order. That's nothing they use for their towers. He was supposed to put together a proposal for me as far as taking them down and see what we have. And we have something not specifically, but from the company in Alliance that we had talked with and got some pricing. So hopefully I can get something from Tri-County soon. We'll know where we're
going. Con-El would be the other one if we're going to look for Con-El.
Con-El?
Con-El. They're in Youngstown. They do a lot of mobile crane activity.
Demolition type?
They've got mobile cranes, but there's somebody that...
C-O-N-E-L-L?
Yeah, C-O-N-N-E-L-L.
Okay.
And they're on Andrews Avenue in Youngstown.
Okay, I can check
but
on that too.
But be somebody, if we're going to get a few bids,
sure,
have them look at it.
Absolutely.
Say it's yours to do what
right.
you want.
Yeah, and take the metal and...
Yeah.
Okay, good. Our step van, the so-called bread truck. If you remember, we had that a few years ago that the band was using to haul equipment in. Talked to Gary Conrad. We're unable to get it started. It's a 1975. So we might be able to get antique plates or historical plates.
You've got money for it.
And the odometer shows 3,094 miles, but we're not sure how many times that's turned over. So, you know, we're paying insurance on it, but we really haven't any use on it. So I'm looking to put an ad in a roundup for somebody if they want to buy that and see, you know, not sure that it's worth much of anything, but looking at that. And then Chuck Sainer also came to me today and said he had somebody with some computers that was doing some work today. And remember last summer, one of our projects was to upgrade the wireless internet in here. So we have our old wireless routers and system. And he said he might know a couple of businesses that might be interested in that. So rather than sitting there and you know, not being used by us for really anything, so I may, we're going to look through the proper procedures of, you know, putting that out, that, you know, we're looking to sell that. So
what are we going to look to do to replace the band vehicle? I mean, is
they, you know what, they just loaded onto a bus.
Loaded on the bus.
Yeah, we haven't used it for a couple. Okay. About the only use we've done with it the last few years was for the fish fry when they use their cardboard that they, in case the grease falls on, load the cardboard into that and take it to the recycling. That's been about it. So it's really, really not been.
So how are we going to do that now?
You know, they'll have to figure something out. We're certainly not going to buy a new van for them, the whole cardboard, I can tell you that. I'm putting together some things to consider for, we had mentioned a couple times about the water operator for our, you know, that's going to have to take effect August 1st, and I've got some information on that that I'll get to you. The Trumbull County inmates have been painting the fence around the stadium. If you've been out and seen that, it looks like a brand new fence.
Yeah, it looks brand new.
The sun is shining, it's bright. Yeah. So I think for $1,000, $1,200 maybe in paint. And
it looks great.
It really, when I first saw it, I thought, my gosh, it looks like a new brand new fence. And again, something I'll put in the newsletter. You know, we didn't spend a ton of money on new fence. You know,
that's good,
that's good for people. No.
Yeah, it shows.
Yeah.
So, I had a couple parents ask me if we replaced it. And I'm like, no, we didn't, you know, because we were
just all down. They're down and around the bottom ends of the stadium and coming up behind the visitors. So they done.
It's amazing. It really does.
It's been back there for a while, the girls' softball field. I know when we originally built that back there, we reused the fence.
Somebody mentioned that, and I'll have to look at that because we might be able to get them to
slap some paint on that too. I know it at the time.
Yeah.
Hey Jeff, anytime they don't have to be in, and they
they enjoy
you, you might as well take advantage of it.
You know, we can look at that. Yeah. And maybe, I mean, the way that fence looks, to throw some paint on that too.
Seriously.
And they're. You know, when I talked to the head warden there, he said they're open to coming into buildings in the summer and painting walls and, you know, anything. So we've got them on the hotline and going to utilize that.
And these by the quality, too. You know, they really,
yeah.
I mean.
Yeah, they've done great. They really have. Yeah. They really have done a great job. So just a quick update on some things.
And really, you wouldn't know they were here if you didn't go out there and walk past them.
Oh, also before I forget, I wrote myself a note and I almost forgot. Graduation Sunday, coming?
1 o'clock.
Yep, he just told us.
I'm asking to make sure you are, so we save you a seat.
Yes.
And I think Lisa is. I'll get a hold of
her.
Yeah, he thought it was at 7, he texted me.
Oh, geez.
Yeah, you'll be doing
the video. I don't know.
Bye, Ryan.
I'll send a text maybe tomorrow, just remind everybody of graduation, be here at 1, anybody let me know who's not coming. Maybe you guys can ignore that.
Okay.
Maybe Mark will be too small.
So speaking of that, I saw something on Facebook, angry parents about the MCCTC graduation.
Yeah,
there was only two schools that didn't have a representative in one of them.
I was out of town that day.
I think, you know,
future years, could we get Mr. Molino or somebody to go?
Boards, you know, and then administration or director.
I heard that this afternoon.
I saw it the other day, and just if anybody could have went, you know, and yeah, I understand you're out of it.
Rightfully so. I heard about it at the academic banquet from the Houstons, and I didn't offer any excuses. We should have been there.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Yeah. I wasn't in that day, and we'll find out. And then there was some mix-up too. The senior breakfast. There were multiple calendars out. Some had it at 8 o'clock. Yes. Some had it at 9 o'clock. And there were kids here at 8 o'clock, and some not here till 9 o'clock. And some started eating at 8:30, and so we got
to
get.
Shelly was ready to have it all set up.
Get that ready to go.
He's about 20 till, so we started.
And then some come early, yeah. And they just, I mean, I don't, that one I don't see as much, but I think we do need to, you know, even if you need to get one of us board members, somebody, you know, to be over there to represent the school, you know.
I
think that's.
We didn't leave at breakfast till 9:30, so everybody was in. We did roll at 9 o'clock. Everybody was there.
Yeah, they all come at different. Yeah. So.
Well, there was confusion on calendars. Okay. And it got changed, and I told my wife, don't go through the cafeteria this morning because we're having breakfast at 8 o'clock. So I didn't even realize it was 9 o'clock till 8:30.
Yeah.
Well, that's one of the things that, you know, if we get the website updated and really use it the way it was supposed to, at that point. You know, that becomes a central point of information.
Mm-hmm. And another thing about scheduling too, and I'm just talking as me as a parent, is just when you have multiple kids. I know I ran back and forth between the boat regatta and elementary field day, and also the awards assemblies. The middle school kind of, you know, ran late, and the elementary was going on, and the different, you know what I mean? So that, a lot of people have different,
well,
you know, so to keep in mind.
I know,
but they were in two different gyms, and
the elementary is going to move theirs to the last day. It used to be the middle school used to do those last day, but because they have locker cleanouts now and they tell the kids not to bring their backpacks because they have activity day on the last day, they were finding certificates and things all over the building. They weren't taking them home. Mm-hmm. So we're just going to move, the elementary is going to just move theirs to the last day, and then middle schools will be on the next to the last day, and that'll work better.
That'd be great.
The boat regatta, we did that a couple years ago. Last year we moved it. They moved the boat regatta. I don't remember why. Maybe because of the weather. So they were expecting bad weather, and they just left it. And so we can rearrange both of either of those. So that's all it is. It's the coordination. But here's the thing: is if there's a rain date, it may end up happening anyway. So you do the best you can. And really, the boat regatta is almost finished before field day even starts, because they take off, I think, at 9, and field day, the picture's at 9, and we start, it's probably 9:30 before we start. So that wasn't as big a deal as the awards, and I get that.
They did overlap, and we were trying to go back and forth and got locked out.
That's a pain,
you know,
yeah.
So
So we are going to change that for next year. We'll be on the last day. Yeah, any suggestions, that's important. If you hear anything, just call. I mean, we need to know that. I tell people that because I've called a couple times when people have said that things are on Facebook. I've called them and I said, it really does help us if we know. It helps us to make things better. So if you would just let us know, that would be a really big important. That would be a lot more helpful than just posting it on Facebook. That would be, because I'm not friends with them on Facebook.
Yeah.
So that would be a big help.
I heard grumblings other than me, or I probably wouldn't have brought it up, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that, and that's what we need to tell the people in the community. It's not really helpful if they put on Facebook if we don't know.
Right.
I'd much rather them call me and let me know. I mean, I won't take offense to it. It only makes us better, so.
Exactly.
Okay. Next item, we need to adjourn to executive session. Any other? Okay, any motion to move to executive session?
Second.
Thank you.
Mrs. Potts? Yes.
Mr. Daniel? Yes.
Mr. Flowers?
Yes.